This video is brought to you by Paperlike. Alright, this will be the first one for the channel. Let me show you how I use my 12.9 inch iPad Pro to create a YouTube thumbnail. From planning to shooting and then editing, the end result will hopefully be something that you'll click on. And by the way, you'll be the judge of that at the end. I'll be posting my long-term iPad Pro review in a few weeks, so stay tuned for that. But I decided to take the opportunity and create a good thumbnail that can hopefully generate decent click-through rates. The first step of the process is inspiration, which I usually find in other videos and in most cases Instagram and Pinterest. Now, spending half an hour usually convinces me that my initial concept is good enough, so I hop onto Procreate to do a rough sketch of what I want to shoot and edit. This year, two key elements distinguish the latest 12.9 inch iPad Pro. That is the M1 chip and the XDR display. It is challenging to do something creative with the actual M1 chip because they're tiny and difficult to demonstrate. So XDR is the key word for this thumbnail. Now in my mind, I want to prop the iPad on a table and sort of peel off the display to showcase the mini LEDs as if they're glowing, showcasing a burst of light, if you will. The other two vital components are the text, which will go last, and my persona, because the thumbnail presence is just what the algorithm doctor prescribed. Once I have the rough idea and concept sketched out, it is time to shoot. Since I'll be doing everything on my own, setting up the camera and taking a photo of myself, I will resort to an app called Camroad, which works fantastic with my Sony cameras and allows me to control the A7 III from a distance. Great for framing and creating high quality selfies. To sell the effects that I usually come up with, I always try and resort to actual physical objects that will give me a real life reference, which I can later on mask off. In the case of this thumbnail, I'll be using a simple blue notepaper that I will tape on the corner of the iPad and actually hold it with my fingers on camera as if I'm really peeling off the screen. I'm not worried at this stage about what is displayed on the screen of the iPad because I will be replacing it digitally later on. With my camera set to manual focus on the iPad and Camroad, I fire up the 5 to 10 second timer and start fooling around, making some shocking and funny faces. I don't usually take too many photos of myself because I find that weird, so 3 shots are enough. Next up, downloading the images from the SD card and moving the work to the iPad itself. Once I have my image, I fire up Lightroom for 2 critical corrections. Although I can go much deeper into Lightroom and really manipulate the image to a pleasant degree, I'll be doing a lot more work in Affinity Photo later, so for now, in Lightroom, all I'll do is a lens correction to fix the distortion and eliminate the lens vignetting, and an auto color and tone correction before exporting to Affinity. By the way, if you end up enjoying this video, subscribe, because why not? Once I've imported the much better looking photo into Affinity Photo, it's time to start bending reality. So the two most important steps are to create 2 masks that will be used to bend the artificially added iPad home screen, which is essentially a screenshot. The first mask will be used to go around the screen of the iPad and around the edges of my fingers. And the second mask will be used to go over the bezel of the tablet, fixing any reflections and imperfections like the blue paper that covers a portion of the bezel due to the angle of the shot. Once I have created the mask, I'll do some distortion tests to see which distortion tool will be ideal for simulating an actual screen bending. At some point, I'll add the mini LED display lighting panel, which I took directly from Apple's website. At this stage, I will have to perform another transformation via the perspective tool to align it as best I can with the corner of the iPad. The image itself is not that great, but I'm not concerned since it will be used underneath some exploding light beams. Once I have created my masks, I will draw a piece of paper or screen with a pen tool, which will essentially be folded or the bent screen itself. Using the real paper upon shooting this photo helps me tremendously at this stage since I have real life reference point that I can use to draw over. This reference point is excellent for shadowing later on as well. So drawing that fold is really simple, and although there are some tiny imperfections on some of my pen outlines, I'm not concerned since I can always go back and correct them as I'll do later. Next, I move towards drawing the shadow cast by the folded screen, which is based on the original blue paper. By using the pen tool again, I'm precise around the edges of my fingers and the forwarded portion of the image, but not so concerned about the right piece of the shadow, since I'll use the eraser tool to gradually fade it out. Playing with the opacity a bit, the end result is good enough for me. After refining the pen outlines, I move forward to draw some highlights around the bottom portion of my fingers. Theoretically, there's light coming from the screen of the iPad. Of course, I can spend few hours to actually draw some natural light, but using the dodge and burn tools for a thumbnail is more than enough, I think. Lighting the top portion of the fold creates the illusion of a real screen bent and simulates the light that will be coming from underneath. By the way, all those color corrections are really simple to apply with a pencil, and it is definitely more precise than using a mouse. Talking about precision, I use a screen protector on my tablet, which is by Paperlike, and it is definitely the very first accessory that I apply on all my iPads. It works in tandem with the Apple Pencil to deliver the closest experience to writing and drawing on actual paper, eliminating the weird pencil on glass feeling, so it's a lot more than just a screen protector. Not to mention that if I were to do one of those thumbnail sessions without Paperlike, I would have spent just as much time when done to wipe off all the nasty fingerprints, which are almost non-existent with the screen protector applied. When ordering Paperlike, in the package you get two screen protectors and everything necessary to make your application straightforward. Be sure to check out the first link in the description below to get your Paperlike, and as always, thanks Paperlike for supporting the channel. So after refining the edges, the next step is finding a good image of a burst of light. Once I find it, I place it underneath the fold and the tablet screen and change the blend mode to lighten, eliminating the blue background and leaving the bright bursts of light. Next up is erasing excess lights and that nasty lorem ipsum text, duplicating the layer two more times to create even more light flares and grouping them for further manipulation. Adding a live light filter gives me the flexibility to play with the light even more, before I add the HSL filter to change the color of the light and make it more popping, as a good friend of mine likes to call it. Using the dodge tool, I add more rim light to my fingers. Again, this is not the coolest way to do it. And off I go to finally set my canvas to the appropriate 16:9 ratio in 4K or 3840x2160. Once I do that, it's time for the fun stuff. Color grading, LUTs, vibrancy, and sharpening where necessary. At some point, I also use the Affinity library to add an artificial haze or smoke around my portion of the image to create more suspense, depth, and generally less flat feeling. Of course, adding a watermark is a necessary step. And finally, a text box that says iPad Pro. Now I wondered where exactly to place that box before I decided to ditch it behind my head by masking it and adding a bit of Gaussian blur to make it actually stand behind my head. And voila, that's the final result. Usually, at this stage, I let the image simmer for about 12 hours before I look at it again and decide on some final changes. Now, while I do that, you be the judge in the video poll and tell me what you think about this thumbnail. Yay or nay? Meanwhile, if you enjoyed this video, you might find my iPad playlist helpful. If you have any questions, please list them in the comment section below or ping me on Twitter. And as always, it's been an absolute pleasure. This is Z. Over and out.